So prepare, say a prayer. Send the word to beware. We'll be over, we're coming over, and we won't come back till it's over over there.
All right, so I made something recently that I never made before. A buddy of mine just graduated from barber school. I'm pretty proud of him because he kind of turned his life around. He'd been working for somebody for, you know, his whole life, like a lot of us have done. And he decided he wanted something a little different. So he pretty much went out and reinvented himself and set a goal, and he decided to go to barber school. And he just is getting ready to graduate here, I think, in the next month or so. And I was really proud of him, and I told him I'd make him a razor for his shop. So I did. And this is it. It's kind of funky, huh? Yeah, it's not exactly traditional or, you know, maybe even right, but this is the best I can do. The reason it looks this way is because I suck at making things that fold. And most straight razors fold. So I've never made a straight razor. I've never even used a straight razor. I don't know anything about them. And I don't like making stuff that I don't really understand that well. So I decided, like I said, to make a fixed blade straight razor because I've tried folding cutting tools before, and I failed miserably. So I decided to go with at least my strength on that. So in order to educate myself, I watched some videos on shaving with a straight razor and kind of did some research and some reading on them. And from what I could tell, the way it's used, and I'm sure there will be a lot of experts out there telling me that this is wrong, and it more than likely is wrong, that's okay. But the way I've seen them used mostly is like this, in this grip here. Which makes sense, you know, I mean, you got a lot of movement and dexterity holding the razor that way. By holding it that way, I realized that that handle right there is a key element to the razor. It lets you turn it back and forth with your fingers pretty easily. Use your thumb and your two fingers and it kind of stabilizes it. So that key element had to be on the fixed blade, I thought. So that's why the wing is there. It does the same thing. I put the wing to the middle fingers there. Kind of hold on to it like that. Same grip. Okay, so I have the same turning ability, dexterity, all that jazz. So now we'll see if I can cut myself badly with this thing. I'll try and shave with it. So here we go.
We did as we were told. We just heard you offer the apology for all the monsters of our times.
Is that correct? Okay, here we go. Here are all those ideas that you know is a bad idea before you ever do it. This is it. Basically dry shaving because all my soap is dry. How the hell do you do this? Your face right here. All you razor guys. Hang on, I think she needs some more sharpening. Hold it back up. I already sharpened it. See what happens. Alright, there you go. Not a complete success at all, but it does shave. It just doesn't shave real great. So maybe my buddy can just use it as a prop. Like I say, it could be my technique. I couldn't get a real smooth shave with either razor, but this one definitely is smoother than the one I made. So sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Alright, there you go. Hopefully he likes it, and hopefully he can make it shave a little better than I can. Thanks for watching.